Hey, it's Eric here. Let's go ahead and talk about making a list in Scratch. Now, a list is essentially a one-dimensional array to store multiple variables. Okay, well, that's what it is, but don't think of it that way, because that's just confusing. Think of it as a way for us to store multiple variables onto a single list. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and step through this by creating a game where every time we touch a fruit, whether it be an apple or a banana, we're going to go ahead and send that to an inventory, to a list. So think of this as just collecting fruit. So we'll go ahead and make a list for this. We'll make the list, and this list is going to be the amount of fruit we've collected. So we'll call it our fruit basket. Okay? Now we'll go ahead and make our list. And okay, so we see in the left here, pretty cool, we have our fruit basket. Now what do we do with this thing? How do we populate this with data? Well, I'm going to have you look over here to the right, and we see all of these different blocks to choose from. Now, this should seem familiar, this first one. This is the checkbox so we can see, we can disable or enable seeing the basket or the list. And all of the data here is actually stored in this variable. So that, again, that should seem pretty familiar. But how do we go about actually adding something to our basket or to our list? Well, that's this block right here. Add thing to fruit basket. So let's go ahead and let's add an apple to the fruit basket. So when the apple is touched, we want to add the apple. So we'll go ahead, click our apple. As you can see, I've outlined the sequence here. So if we're touching, if sprite one is touching the apple, something can happen. So let's make that something, add apple. Okay. So if all goes according to plan, when sprite 1 is touching the apple, we should add it to the list. Let's go ahead and try it out. Boop. Nice. Okay. So you can see as I'm on this, it's collecting constantly. So let's go ahead and put some wait time in there. So we'll say wait 1 second before you give me the next apple. So there you go. A little bit more manageable. Very cool. Now let's do the same thing again for the bananas. So we'll simply click bananas. And then we'll jump here to our data and say, you know what? When I am touching, when sprite one is touching that banana, go ahead and add it. Add a B-A-N-A-N-A-S to the fruit basket. And let's throw a little bit of wait time in there too so we don't have the same mistake as earlier. So everything's running. So if all goes according to plan, we'll see bananas. Nice. Apple, banana. Cool. So we'll jump back to our data. Well, you can see our list got a little long there. So say we want to delete something from the list. That's right down here. So delete one of fruit basket. Well, what's one mean? Well, one is actually the position here. So right now this is the 68th position. So if we were going to go ahead and delete one, that would be deleting the first thing here on our list. So we could do that, but say we want to delete the last thing. So we want to get rid of this banana. We could simply do that. Go ahead, test it out. Say we want to delete everything. We have that option too. So you can delete all. So there you go. Our basket is now clear. We're back to square one. So, you know, knowing these two blocks are going to get you going on creating awesome lists. But now I want to jump in, you know, if you're interested, into some of the more nuanced blocks that aren't, you know, as essential, but very powerful and really do have a place in your project. So we see right here, we have a both insert and replace. So if we have a list, I'll go ahead and populate the list with some fruit here. You'll see that we'll have an option with these blocks to start inserting into certain positions on our list. Because right now they just jump to the bottom here, and they always add to the bottom. Well, say I want this new fruit to go to the top instead. So that's pretty simple to do. We'll say, you know, insert bananas at one, at position one. So we'll go ahead and delete this block here. And so get rid of that guy and just say, you know, insert. I want you to always be inserting here bananas at position one. So we'll go ahead and throw the wait time. And we should see now that the bananas, instead of going here, are going to boop right here at the top. So we'll go ahead and try it out. Bam, there you go. So cool. Let's go ahead and look at this one. So replace item. So say we want to, you know, cap our list at 8 items, right? So instead of always at this point adding, let's say, you know what, whatever fruit you now collect, let's replace that with our first fruit. So we can go ahead and say, you know what, replace Our last item in the list, so we go ahead and say our last item, which is now an apple, replace that with a banana that we just got. So again, we'll wait a second here. So it's pretty self-explanatory. So this apple is going to be replaced because it's the last item. So we'll go ahead, see that. Whoop, there you go. Pretty cool. So I know we've been talking about lists for a couple minutes now. So let's just wrap this up and talk about these last three blocks here just briefly. These three blocks allow you to sort of dig into the data here for other uses. So, item one of fruit basket. So I could see using this to have, our scratch cat say, hey, I just picked up a banana. Or, for this one, you could have the length of the list. So, if we could say, what if we say, you can only collect four things of fruit. So you can make an if-then statement saying, if the length exceeds four, so if the length of the list exceeds four, stop collecting fruit altogether. And likewise, we have here, if the fruit basket contains, say, an apple, then something happens. So these are all really useful blocks that can take your list here to the next level. So definitely check these out when you're creating a list, and then use these to your advantage.